Thanks to Udacity for supporting PBS Digital Studios.
Quick, can you pick all the labradoodles from the fried chicken? How many labradoodles can you see? Generally, people are pretty good at knowing what we're looking at, but it's been reported that artificial intelligence struggles to tell the difference between these pictures, or between chihuahuas and blueberry muffins, sheepdogs and mops, puppies and bagels, or Dalmatians and ice cream. Is there something particular about dogs that computers just don't get? Well, not really. Researchers have, thankfully, shown that dogs and food can be pretty well distinguished, with some 90% accuracy. This is thanks to artificial neural networks, algorithms that are structured in a similar way to your brain. In the last episode, we explored how artificial neural networks are really good at finding patterns in data. To learn something, the network takes lots of examples, say songs with many instruments and vocals. It works out what makes auditory patterns that resemble a voice, then it uses those patterns to isolate a voice among the other sounds. With images, after a deep neural network has seen thousands of sample dog photos, it can learn what a dog is and identify dogs in new photos as accurately as you can.
Or almost as accurately.
Remember, there was some error in the dog-chicken caper.
The trouble starts when the input signals are just too similar. So if the pattern that says labradoodle is the same fuzzy curly pattern that makes up this sheepskin that I bought a few years ago, how is a computer to tell which is which? So it might seem like a trivial problem. So what if a computer can't tell someone's dog from food or a sheepskin? But this is an example of how hard it is to close the gap between machine and human intelligence.
If we develop incredibly precise algorithms, it might mean that if an example only changes a little, the machine changes its mind about what's in the photo and struggles to understand that a photo of a dog with a hat is still a dog. And this is one of the hardest problems in artificial intelligence: common sense. How can we build machines that have common sense? So they don't have to be trained on every instance of all the objects and animals that exist.
And coding common sense is not the only problem engineers have to solve. Another thing that AI does is that it can hallucinate. It can be tricked into seeing and hearing things that don't exist. Some researchers even tricked a computer to see this cat as guacamole. This happens because no matter how accurate AI systems get in identifying objects in images, they're still vulnerable to what's called adversarial examples, like our cat.
Adversarial examples fool AI because they carry a special pattern of noise in the image, from things like lighting or texture, that leads to the machine interpreting the image entirely differently. Here, MIT researchers 3D printed a turtle that, because of altering the pattern on its shell, the artificial network sees as a rifle. Neural networks can struggle with 3D objects because they're normally trained with 2D images. Still, this cat photo is recognized as guacamole. But when it's slightly rotated, this pattern of noise disappears, so it's correctly identified as a cat. Us humans can pretty obviously recognize these images, but the machine sees something that's not there. It hallucinates.
To be fair, computer vision has seen significant progress in recent years, and in some cases, computer vision is more accurate than a human's.
But adversarial examples are a big concern for artificial intelligence. Sure, AI is great at seeing images, but we need to do a lot more work in training AI to confidently recognize 3D objects. When image recognition is applied to things like driverless cars, a machine hallucinating can have big implications. For now,
here's a final question for you. Given that people eventually end up looking like their dogs, are there people out there who look like a blueberry muffin? Think about it. Do I then look like fried chicken? As always, can't wait to read your comments.
Now, just before you go, I wanted to thank Udacity for supporting PBS Digital Studios. Udacity is an online organization that offers nano degree programs, and they have a library of online courses that you can take if you want to learn something new, start a new career, change careers, upskill, reskill, or just for personal enrichment. So check it out at udacity.com/braincraft. Thanks, Luna.